Sir, please tell us about how do you see this event in the backdrop of changes happening in India or in global rounds?
So I think this event is very relevant for legal professional and professional, whether it is the in-house counsel community or the practicing lawyers or the law firms, because India is, as you all know, is a growing market. We are growing at a decent rate of 7 to 8%, and we are attracting the investments. And the more and more investment happens, I think that will lead to, a lot of legal work also coming in, whether it is, acquiring a company, so mergers, amalgamation, acquisitions. And then obviously when investment happens, there are bound to disputes which will happen. So dispute resolving, as you know, in our ranking, global ranking in terms of ease of doing business, one of the things which is actually keeping our ranks from going further improving is enforcement of contracts. So that becomes very relevant. And that is where I think resolving disputes to arbitration or even mediation has to pick up in India. I think this event is very relevant, and next time I think there's a suggestion that you should include mediation as a topic also, which is very important.
And sir, my next question would be, as a general counsel, how's your perspective about managing risk in terms of mergers and acquisition happening?
Oh, risk is very, very important. So like me, I'm not only the general counsel, I'm also the chief risk officer for my company. So risk management comes very naturally to, the chief legal officer or the general counsel, because we are kind of gatekeepers, the business will be always eager to do a transaction, and they will not see what can go wrong, or even if they see, they become blindsided because they are more interested in doing the deal. So I think risk is very important in terms of doing diligence of the business and not getting carried away by just the commercial. What can go wrong? Is there a plan B? And I think due diligence and doing diligence about the business, the regulatory aspects, the legal aspects, because many times litigation are not, you cannot really predict what kind of legal issue can come in. So I think risk management is very, very, very important. And it's a, whenever you do any M&A, there is a due diligence which happens. And you should always, if you are on the buy side, you should ask the seller to make maximum disclosure, because that helps you. And it is always good for the seller to also make maximum disclosures, because that helps in terms of settling settling the consideration. So it's very important.
So my last question would be, how do you see the three things which we must undertake or we must do to make sure India becoming a next arbitration hub?
Yeah, very relevant question. I think for India to become an arbitration hub, I think we should move, at least for corporates, to an institutional arbitration, because ad hoc takes a lot of time, and there's it becomes very difficult for parties to manage the in terms of managing the arbitrator, in terms of date, and there are a lot of logistics issues. And also institution arbitration brings their own set of rules, so it's much easier to navigate. That's point number one. And I think we have to move away from only having judges as arbitrators. We can get people who are trained arbitrators who understand commercial disputes, and if wherever there are technicalities involved, you should get technical expert also. That's point number one. And I think now we are slowly moving to era where intervention by the courts is minimum. So I think that is one which will, and the most important part is the execution of the awards. And sometimes execution takes a lot of time, because award is ultimately a piece of paper unless you execute and you recover. So I think if on execution, the courts which are below the metro and tier one cities, because sometimes you have to go and file an execution in remote part of the country to a district court where the asset may lie. So I think there's a little bit of training which the Honorable Supreme Court and the high courts can conduct for the lower judiciary for execution. And also sometimes you have to go for Section 11 relief, Section 9 relief, interim relief to a lower court. So I think a little bit of training on the commercial aspects to a lower judiciary will really help.